各位尊敬的牧长、弟兄姊妹和来宾们平安，我是夏维柱，是基督使者协会新会长的甄选委员会主席。那么我在仅此呢代表基督使者协会的董事会还有同工们，特别欢迎大家今天来参加柏有成博士的新会长的就职典礼跟任命仪式。那么今天的节目呢都在程序单上，所以我就不多讲。那在这个开始的今天开始的时候呢，我请现任的董事们都站起来好不好，是因为他们，我在这里代表他们欢迎大家。 So I ask all the current board members to stand up. And because it's on behalf of you, I'm welcoming everyone here. Please see that.And we also invite those former board members to stand up. We actually welcome you returning, former board members. And now we invite all the pastors, elders to stand up, and we give you a special welcome. 我们请牧师长老们啊站一下，我们特别欢迎大家，好，欢迎，请坐。那么在我们开始的时候，让我们一同来祷告。As we start a gathering, let's give a word of prayer. Our Heavenly Father, we thank you and we praise you for you are good and your love endures forever. We thank you for your unfailing love.And your wonderful deeds. May your name be glorified. As we gather here for the commissioning service and the celebration of Dr. Yu Chenbo, we give the thanks deep from our hearts. We thank you for your salvation to us through Jesus Christ and your watching over us every day. We thank you for your countless blessing to AFC as well as your faithfulness in the past.And we thank you for your calling to Reverend Moses Chow, Reverend David Chow, all the AFC staffs, and all the volunteer co-workers from many churches so that the AFC becomes a blessing to countless church and countless people in such a way that your name was glorified. We also thank you for your calling to Dr. Yu Chenbo. It's your calling.And guidance led him to AFC and serving faithfully over many years. And we ask you to richly bless him as he step up to be the new president. As we start the commissioning service and the celebration, we ask you to bless us and may your name be glorified throughout the events. We thank you, we praise you.And we ask all this in Jesus' precious name. 慈爱的天父，我们要谢谢你，我们要感谢你，因为你本为善，你慈爱存到永远。愿人因你的慈爱和你向人所行的奇事都称颂你，把荣耀都归于你。当我们在这里举行柏有成博士任命仪式和庆典的时候，我们要从内心深处对你发出这样的赞美和感谢。我们感谢你借主耶稣基督赏赐我们救恩，也看顾保守我们。我们要感谢你在过去的岁月里给基督使者协会赐下恩典，你的信实和所赐的福分。我们感谢你的恩召，在过去的岁月里使用了周老牧师、周牧师、使者众同工和众教会自愿摆上的弟兄姊妹，让基督使者协会成为众教会众人的祝福，也让他们的服事荣耀了你的名，蒙你的悦纳。我们也为即将上任的新会长柏有成博士来感谢你，是你自己的恩召和引导把他带到 AFC， 把他们夫妇都带来这里一同的服事，并让有成博士在这里忠心服事多年，今日又接会长一职，求主你大大的来赐福他。我们把今天的聚会交在恩主你的手中，愿我们在这里的任命仪式和庆典让你的名得着荣耀和称颂，也蒙你的悦纳。我们这样祈求感谢祷告都是奉主耶稣基督圣名，阿们。 So we'll invite Reverend Kam to lead us with a worship service. So 我们请姜牧师带领我们做今天的敬拜。
Let's all stand. 让我们起立，我们一同的来赞美我们主，唱颂我们的主。我的心，你要唱颂主，凡在我里面的都唱颂主的圣名。请坐 ，please be seated.
There is a story behind every name. Our story began with a young Princeton graduate who answered the call to pioneer the mission in Nanjing, China, in 1874. Charles Lehman left his family in Paradise, Pennsylvania, to become one of the first.Protestant missionaries in China. When he first arrived in Nanjing, no one wanted to rent rooms to a foreigner. He slept outside a tea house for 2 years until he settled in a humble boat floating on the Qinghuai River. Charles Lehman labored and witnessed the first wave of Chinese revival. His daughter, China Mary, and Christiana Tsai, also known as the Queen of the Dark Chamber, continued the ministry until they were forced out in 1949. On the other side of the world, two other exiled Chinese missionary couples received the same vision for reaching the overseas Chinese while China was closed. In 1963, they founded Ambassadors for Christ in the U.S., one of the first ministries dedicated to serving Chinese in North America. The 1965 Immigration Act by President Lyndon Johnson paved the way for more Chinese students to come to the U.S. for studies and to remain afterwards. AFC co-workers performed multiple roles at the same time, including visiting various campuses, distributing Christian literature, doing evangelism, and encouraging students to establish Bible study groups. It was not uncommon to wear out a vehicle every 2 to 3 years. During these times of few Chinese Christian resources, AFC began to publish Ambassadors magazine and started to host trainings, camps, and special gatherings for the student believers. The Pine Brook Summer Conference became the flagship event for campus fellowships across the country. Some 50 years later, many former students became leaders in strategic ministries. Most campus Bible groups also evolved into churches. Today, AFC has grown even further. We send full-time missionaries to reach the college students and scholars on campus. We publish and distribute high-quality Chinese literature throughout the world. With help from donors and volunteers, many critical resources are distributed for free to the most needed areas, including China. Till today, we have shipped over 5 million pieces of literature. As a parachurch mission, we emphasize close partnerships with local churches. Since 1983, AFC has been hosting the Triennial Chinese Mission Convention with local churches, aiming to mobilize the Chinese to become a vital mission force among and beyond our own people. Since the number of Chinese studying and living overseas has exponentially increased, we believe AFC's mission has become even more urgent. The new era has brought upon us new challenges and opportunities. Campus, internet, and publishing realms have all become battlefields to win over Chinese intellectuals. AFC continues to adapt and grow, as it has throughout its history, to be relevant to the changing culture of Chinese. Our new focus on media strategies will carry the message even further. Nearly 100 years after Charles Lehman left, AFC built its headquarters in his hometown of Paradise, Pennsylvania. Almost every weekend, Chinese churches and students from all over the country come to AFC's Great Commissioning Training Center to be equipped and inspired. Behind every story, there is a story of God. What is your role in His story? Will you join us in this amazing unfolding story? So we are ambassadors with you.
Warmest greetings. I would like to personally welcome each one of you and so glad that you can be here today. As I look out the audience, I can see many familiar faces and many distinguished guests among us. Unfortunately, I do not have time to introduce each one of you and to express appreciation. However, there are a couple people that I must say something. The first one is our special guest, Pastor Albert Lam, all the way from San Diego here today. He has volunteered his time for a long time as a chief editor of AMS Magazine, and he's the mentor of Dr. Po Yuchen. And then also, we appreciate so much Dr. Warren Shaw from New Jersey as the leader in the search committee for the president. And And then also Roger Gong from Austin, Texas has been our board chair for 6 years and really appreciate for your service. And also we'd like to thank John Huang, Dr. John Huang from Rutgers University, Rutgers, New Jersey, and he will be speaking later on through online and to exhort the new president. For close to 60 years, God's mighty hands has been leading AFC from one generation to the next generation. Today, we witness together a significant moment in AFC history as Dr. Bo Yuchent is commissioned to be AFC 3rd president. I'm most grateful to God and to the entire board and search committee for them to dedicate it and prayerfully, anonymously electing him to be the next president. Our God is a God of history. He is sovereign, and we can rest in his faithfulness. His mighty hand lead us in amazing story, in amazing way. You know that 30 years ago, in 1992, Dr. Bo Yuchent dedicated his life to the Lord at Chinese Mission Convention under the preaching of the first president of AFC. While he was a student, grad student at Cornell. And then 20 years later, after he dedicated, which is 10 years ago, in 2012, he served as AFC board and then later on as a board chair. 7 years ago, he responded to God's call after decades as professor and researcher. He responded to God's call in 2015 for full-time ministry as AFC executive director. And I appreciate and enjoy the privilege of serving together with him for the last 7 years. Now in 2022, which is 30 years after he's dedicated his life, God has prepared him as a new president and a leader of AFC. As an executive director, he is well received by the board, staff, and supporters, friends, and he has represented AFC in preaching, teaching, writing, connecting with pastors and Chinese churches. I'm most grateful that he has developed good understanding of AFC ministry and is ready to take up the position of the president. For the past months, the board, we have been working together with him for the transition, and then also the staff leadership has worked together for a smooth transition and create a stronger leadership team. Dr. Bo is humble, gifted, and fully committed to God and his ministry. I thank the Lord for sending us such a distinguished and capable leader. I'm confident that God will do great things, use him to lead AFC toward a greater fruitful ministry in the days ahead. And I believe that when God called, God guide, God enabled, for God is faithful. And now to him who is able to do immeasurably more than all we can ask or imagine, according to his power that is at work within us, to him be glory and in the church and in Christ Jesus throughout all generations, forever and ever. Amen. God bless.
Dear Yuchent, congratulations on your appointment as the president of AFC. I'm honored by your invitation to say a few words on this auspicious occasion. I know you love stories, so I will tell you a story today. This is a wonderful story. It's got angels and ghosts giants and dragons, man-eating fish, and the smooth-talking donkey. But this story is unlike any other stories I've heard before. The great author makes this story a living narrative. He creates all the characters, gives them specific backgrounds, and marks out their appointed times and the boundaries of their dwelling places. Then he let each character to decide how they would act and what they would say while they were on stage. In 1965, Congress passed a new Immigration Act. More and more Chinese students came over to study, unaware that the author has inserted an exciting chapter on the Chinese Bible study movement on the North American campuses. 2 years prior, three characters, let's call them the three C's, MC, TC, and LC, they all were burdened to serve these students and form an organization in Washington, DC. They aim to win the Chinese intellectuals for Christ. AFC was born. In 1965, one of these CBSs was formed on the campus of Cornell by a newly baptized physicist student. But he did not know what he was doing, so he asked for help from AFC. Soon, MC came. He was funny, energetic, and he was super helpful. MC said to the students, "Fear not, just do what you can, and God will take care of the rest." And the Cornell CBS grew. 24 years later, a young man with an unusual talent and a name with an unusual spelling arrived at Cornell. He found his way to the CBS and was baptized. Thus, a new journey has begun for him. For there is an ancient restlessness that stirred deep in his soul. Even though Ithaca is a lovely place, he would still long for a far better country. Another 24 years will pass, and this searching young man will find AFC in Paradise, Pennsylvania. He went there to serve as a doorkeeper of some sorts. He was very happy and decided to stay there full time. 10 years would pass, and he found himself given the responsibility to continue the story that the three C's started 60 years ago. Yes, Yuchen, you are that man. But of course, you knew that all along. The question now is how that grand narrative is to continue. We don't know if the future already exists. Perhaps time, like space, is simply just there. You see, this mysterious story is both entirely written, but not yet fully told. In fact, the story is still being updated by all these characters. Blaise Pascal once said that this great author has instituted prayers to give the dignity of causality to the characters in his story. Even though the author allows his characters to take part in the story making, yet he nevertheless guides the story to the grand finale as he has prescribed. Of course, his story, which we usually pronounce quickly as history, because this is our story. With all the blessings that I can muster, Yuchen, may the great author write an ever-increasing part for you in his story. So pray hard, learn your part, know your lines, and play the role the great author has intended for you. The end. May the Lord richly bless you and establish the work of your hands. Amen.
So actually, before I came, I asked what language should I use? And I was told that whatever you like to do. So I wrote my script in Chinese. So for those who don't know Chinese, so you can take a break and imagine that you are listening to a meaningful message. That's it, a few minutes. So, 非常的感谢神，我有几分钟的时间来分享我的感受。我巴不得他们给我50分钟，但是没办法，因为今天有很多重要的项目。不过 you know, 时间是相对的。非常的感谢神。Before 我讲一些的这个给一些友情的话，我必须感谢神一件事情。我做牧师哈，那么神也把一些 model 放在我的周围，成为我的榜样，成为我的学习激励。其中一位神的仆人是周大卫牧师，我认识他，其实是最近这十几年才比较亲密，但是当然他是使者的那个会长，大家都认识他这样子。那么每次想到周牧师的时候呢，我就想到天使。是以赛亚这个第六章那个Saphirim 那种撒拉佛天使，他们这个天使的特点呢，就是很喜欢用翅膀遮脸，翅膀来遮脚，然后用两个翅膀来去飞翔，是隐藏的侍奉。周牧师呢，他是一个非常谦卑的神的仆人，他常常把自己隐藏在别人的后面，就逼着我们这些人就抛头露面这样子，出来啊，就出来这样子。他是后面就不断的给我们鼓励，给我们机会。有时候看见一些的这个杂志啊，一些的我们大会的一些的 magazine， 他都没有他名字，甚至照片也没有，名字也没有，都躲在哪里去了这样子。我知道他就是专心，他要服侍神，他个人的那个的名字出现不出现对他是不重要的。 I think that's what a leader is. That's what a leader is. 所以我感谢神，神把周牧师放在我的旁边，让他学习。今天感谢神是一个使者学为一个很重要的里程碑转折点，也是个历史的时刻，非常非常的重要。我很感谢神我们这个聚会我们叫是 pass the baton教棒，最近我常常思想这个字教棒，因为我也差不多要教棒，所以一直想这个问题。我听见那个牧长对我说，哎，我现在也要教棒，所以呢我要好好去想怎么去教法，我不要丢棒 throw the baton。 他说今天很多教会很多的机构不能够 sustain， 因为很多人就丢棒就走了这样子，没有教棒，没有准备整个的过程。我这次感谢神我知道这次的甄选委员会整个的过程呢，是经过长期的等候，谨慎的祷告，全面的考虑，各方的印证，细心的观察，还有最后是圣灵的印证，等于说什么呢，就好像整个的过程呢，就好像是经过这个的提炼压缩还有这个被过滤出来的那个人这样子压缩体验过滤很多很多的这个同工的那个，比如说是那个教棒者他的那个的支持，受棒者的那个顺服的心，还有 search committee 同工的认可，还有董事会的成员，还有 office 同工的支持，还有外面其他教会的牧长的这个 confirmation。 你想想看，经过那么多关，我说我的话 I don't think I like it。 但是神的护照，神的命定 appointment 一来的话，你没办法逃，你没办法逃，你就要快快乐乐的接受这个的事情。感谢神。 我想最后一句话，我个人作为一个 quote unquote 最追求做一个好的一个的普通领袖的一个 personal creed， 一个自我的生命的一个个人的生命的格言，很重要的一点，我觉得我自己学习是说，常常应该有一种的 constant awareness of your unworthiness, but at the same time covered、by God's strengthening and His upholding in the whole journey. Constant awareness, deep awareness of my unworthiness.但是同时 cover、by 神他自己的这个他的 immeasurable strengthened, covered and upheld by his immeasurable grace. 这是我个人的学习这么多年。神的恩典，我举了几个字要送给友晨。我们一生 要记得一辈子都是恩典，好像保罗说，我得救是本乎恩， that's it.然后保罗也说什么呢？我今天成了何等样的人，也是神的恩才成的。甚至他说什么呢？他说 It's because of God's mercy that I have this ministry. 是因为主的怜悯，我有这个侍奉的机会。不是我怜悯上帝，是上帝怜悯我。这个一直他就是 aware， 我不配的，全是神的恩典。另外是神的恩赐，大家都是牧长。我不要讲这个恩赐的定义，不要讲，但是有一件事情很重要的，也是我们所以学习的，原来神的恩赐会按照你的侍奉的成长逐步的嫁给你的。昨天有晨跟我 share 他的那个宏图大计、在未来、这样子，我为他很感谢神，他有意向，他是个意向的人。但是我想想，若是要成就他所讲给我听的，他起码要活到121岁，还要比摩西多活一年才能够完成。然后呢，他不是单只需要这个5000两银，他需要50000两的银子才能够完成这个。但是感谢神，他现在口袋没有，他就5001是吧？但是神会慢慢从5000到那个时候，当有需要的时候，神会给他到50000。最后一个。第一个是恩典，第一个是恩赐，第三个是个恩膏。我们发现有很多人有恩赐，但是没有恩膏。用我用比较 charismatic description， 就是说神的恩膏是圣灵的一个临在，圣灵的充满，圣灵的加力 empowerment， 就是好像大卫他的那个的小石头啊，他要打哥利亚的那个小石头小石块。一般来说呢，我们打这个棒球啊，很快的速度是110 miles per hour， 打出去已经很厉害了。我们也知道说要把一个石头送到人的头脑里面的那个速度要起码 1000 miles per hour 才能够打死一个人，100里都打不死。所以我相信当大卫认出那个小石头的时候呢，恩膏的意思说神把它 accelerate， 把那块石头 accelerate 加速，他才能够达到把哥利亚打下来。但是他要不要打呢？他还是要打。他还要选石头吗？他还要选石头。但是放在神的手中的时候，那个的 anointing， 那个 anointing， 那个 acceleration， 就成就一些事情，是你的才华、你的才干、你的才气加起来，甚至什么资源加起来都不能够达到的那个目的，因为有神的恩膏，就好像五饼二鱼喂饱5000人一样。所以让我们彼此的劝勉，特别把这句话送给友晨，一切都是恩典，恩赐到时候嫁给你，恩膏是我们侍奉成功的最重要的一个关。谢谢各位，愿主赐福。友晨，
Now we commissioning
you granting to Chen.In accordance with the authority
given to me by the Board of Director of Ambassador for Christ, I'm going to ask you the following questions in front of the congregation, and please answer them with sincerity and honesty. First, do you believe in the Orthodox Christian doctrine as outlined in the Confession of Faith of AFC?And do you reject all teachings contrary to it?
Yes, I do.
Second, do you believe wholeheartedly in the organization's mission of reaching Chinese intellectuals for Christ in this generation, and believe that God himself has called you to accept the office of president.
Yes, I do.
Third, are you committed to faithfully carrying out your duty as president and to cooperate with the board of directors and your team of co-workers in fulfilling the vision of the organization with a godly life example?
Yes, I do.
Brother Yu Chen, since you have accepted this office in front of the congregation, I now announce you as the new president of the Ambassadors for Christ. Invite five pastors coming up to lay a hand and to encourage, and also Yu Chen and also his wife.
Dear Heavenly Father, we come to your presence. This is a such a sacred moment, because we witness that it is you who build your work.是你自己呼召你的工人，亲爱的主啊，这不单单是一个交盼的时刻，这更是一个我们见证你继续你事工的一个时刻。我们心里向你献上感恩，我们也感谢你，因为使者协会的成立不单单是60年之前的事情，更是可以追溯到在19世纪的里曼的这个家族。亲爱的主啊，在那个时候你就已经知道今天要发生何事，在那个时候你就开始预备你的工人，一代一代的工人，你的工人终究要过去，但是你的事工继续的推展。今天你呼召我们的弟兄在担任使者协会的这个会长，主啊，就像当年你呼召大卫一样，让他要服侍了那一代的人，服侍了这一代的中国的这个知识分子。我们切切地求你施恩和眷顾，照着运行在衡量心里面的大能大力，充充足足地成就一切超乎我们众人的所求所想。愿你在我们的弟兄，在我们的姐妹，在这个使者服侍的团队，在这服侍的事工里面，充充足足地得到荣耀，让你自己的心得到满足。亲爱的主，我们特别为衡量师母祷告。主啊，你也知道做一个忙碌的一个丈夫背后的支持者何等的不容易。主啊，求你特别祝福我的姐妹，让她心里面主啊能够服侍的喜乐，有一天在天上的赏赐会比她丈夫的赏赐还更大，因为她所做的事情是别人看不见的。我们感谢你，我们这样子祷告是奉主耶稣基督的圣名。阿们。
Father God, we come before you grateful first and foremost for your gospel, for it is the power of God unto salvation for everyone who believes. We thank you for the gospel who saved us from the penalty of our sins. Thank you for the gospel that saved us from the influence, the power of sin.Lord, we thank you that you use your gospel to save us from ourselves, from the idols in our lives, and giving us true purpose, true identity, true hope in Christ. And so we lift up Dr. Bohr and as ambassador for Christ to you, Lord. We pray that the power of your gospel will fall afresh on him. Lord, that as he serves as the president, may he serve in the humility that the gospel brings. May he serve in the power that the gospel brings. May his identity be rooted in the gospel.Lord, and give him wisdom, give him vision, give him power, give him strategy, give him all that he needs, Lord, to serve you well for the sake of proclaiming the gospel from here to the ends of the earth. And Lord, we also pray that you will give him gospel community. Lord, for all of us who are not just here today to support him, I pray for the staff of AFC, pray for the board, pray for everyone here that we will be that gospel community around him.Lord, for him, that we will pray for him, we will love him, and we will lovingly encourage him and remind him, Lord, to be rooted in the gospel. Lord, we pray that you will help them not only start well and continue to do well and finish well. Lord, we've seen too many leaders left the path of the gospel, do not finish well. But we pray for Dr. Bohr that he will finish well and that he will be a powerful testimony, a humble testimony of the power of your gospel in a person's life. And use him, use Ambassador for Christ, that we truly would become effective, humble, faithful ambassador of the gospel of Jesus Christ. We thank you, pray for your protection, pray for your joy to fill his heart as he serves you. We pray in Jesus' name, amen. Amen.
Let's all stand with your hymns to response. 我们一同起立，我们唱一首诗歌，是按照基督使者协会的口号，我们来唱这首诗歌。我希望我们先唱中文一遍，然后我们再唱英文，把基督使者的 mission 让我们大家一同的唱出来。
He is Lord of heaven, Lord of earth, He is
seated, 请坐。
Good morning, everyone. It's really nice to see every person here. Thank you. A special thank you for taking the time to come here. First of all, thank Brother Roger and David for your leadership and for your friendship all throughout the years. I did not prepare any script, so I think I have the freedom to use either English or Chinese. Can I have the first slide?The reason we're here today is, like Elder Zhang Huang says, I love story. So someone told me that the most powerful words in English, six words, let me tell you a story. So the story always started from 1989 when I was a grad student and I went to Cornell. And there, so I think Tang Bing Mu Shi here today?Thank you, Pastor Tang Bing, his pastor from Cornell, coming all the way down here. I still remember back in 1989, I was not a believer, and I met a very young, cute, beautiful kid, and his name is Daniel. Is Daniel here? 30 years later, now he's calling Daniel. At that time, he was a small, cute little boy, and his parents become my role model, put their lives, energy,train me, disciple me in such a way that I was ready to receive Jesus Christ. And of course, at turning points in 1992 CMC under Reverend Moses Chow's calling, I went down the altar. I have no idea what the story can unfold in front of me. All I know is at that time, remember, I say, from this time, my schedule is yours. And fast forward, graduate fromCornell, went to San Diego, and God sent me another big mentor, Pastor Alba Lane. He demonstrated a true leader, the humility that what he just shared with me in the 93. In that short 2 years in San Diego, that's the time when my spiritual life really been taking off, been mentored by many, many dear brothers and sisters along the way.And of course, fast forward in 1999, I moved to Virginia and also starting to meet quite a few very good brothers and sisters. I think Peng Wei Ma Li, are you here today? Put this way, 20 years ago, I have no way to work with this brother. But God has changed both of us. Now we are the best friend in Christ, in the brothers in Christ.And Peng Wei, Ma Li, they also been a huge impact in my lives in such a way that Peng Liang and I been continue to watch their life unfold in front of me and their stories. And fast forward, in 2003, I started my first public speaking ministry in a place called Refreshing Mountain. And through that period of time, I was able to be got invited to more and more retreats and study and Bible study groups and sharing stories, the gospel of Jesus Christ. And fast forward in 2010, I was preaching at State University of New York, Stony Brook. On that particular campsite, I met two workers from AFC, Brother Timothy Su and the other sister, Doreen Tang.Two of them invited me, say, hey, do you want to come to AFC to attend a campus ministry strategic forum? I said, sure. And that's how I connected with Pastor David. And little did I know, 2 weeks later, I got a phone call from one board member, Gao Lichuan, Ray Scout. Say, hey, do you want to join the board member? I said, what does that mean? Because during that 2010, I think that's God's intervention. I had a chance to first meet David because in 1992, he was standing up there and I share my story, how his father touched my life. And fast forward, of course, 2012 became the chair, the board. At the time I was joking, now I'm David's boss. But it was at that time I began to realize the AFC is such a blessed ministry that God has used in this beautiful God-ordained ministry to reach out multiple Chinese intellectuals in this generation. And I began to ask myself, 1992, I made that dedication. Say, my schedule is yours. Then what is your schedule? What is my schedule in your time? 2014, my dad is in ICU. But at that time, I got a phone call from Chiu Fang, Professor Chiu Fang invited me to Dallas to preach. And that was actually Reverend Moses Chow's, his church. And then I went back to Taiwan, had a chance, privilege to share the gospel with my elder, an ailing father, and led him to Christ. And Brother Chiu Fang, when I came to the campsite, Chiu Fang and his pastor at that time, Pastor Choi, told me, God has something great in store for you. Better listen up. And little did I know, 2014, during our monthly meeting with David, David asked me, have you ever considered to come to AFC to serve? I say, thank you, but no thank you. But then, another historical event, in 2014, I went to Harrisburg Alliance Church. At that time, I met Brother Sun Hong. Through Brother Sun Hong, then I met Pastor Simon Chan, Chen Qingwen Mushi at that time. And he said, oh, because I know Ma Li and Peng Wei, they're in their church. I said, wow. And he invited me to his family retreat in 2014. Little did I know, that retreat, the campsite, is Refreshing Mountain, 2003. The very first time I had my papi speaking. And that Sunday morning, my message is Jacob wrestling with God. So I have very important decision to make in front of my life. God called me through David, and now I'm wrestling. What should I do? So, Pastor Simon, that particular event, actually, that message is for me. I need to rest myself in God. So I promised David, I said, David, if God allows me, then I will join AFC in 2015. 2015, June, is my last month in University of Virginia. I went to South Africa, and Pastor Tony Liang, Liang Zhongjie Mushi, he wrote an email when I was in South Africa. He invited me to be their speaker in 2016 in their gospel camp. So I accepted. 2015, July, I came here as the executive director. In 2016, I went to the campsite again, Refreshing Mountain. Fast forward amount of that time span, I realized God has really called me, just like this contagion, this network. Here, I'm telling you my story, but no, my story is because your participation. You are also co-writing my story. But more importantly, that's the next slide. I wrote, like Zhang Huang, Elder Zhang Huang told, this is God's story. We all of us are probably just a little speckle in this 85 megabytes resolution. If you blow it up, you are probably just a dark color or just a yellow color, a green color. But what I learned from this picture is God called me to faithfully, in that particular pixel, to faithfully display that value, that hue, that temperature at that time in such a way that when we zoom in out from God's external perspective, you're going to see this grandiose story that unfold in front of us. Because if I did not faithfully display that color, this picture will be incomplete. And here I saw each one of you. You all have made a special in my heart, in my life. There's too many people I want to thank here, Pastor, because Pastor Hugo, I know Pastor Terrence, Liu Yihuang Mushi, and Li Shaoyuan Mushi. There's so many people I want to thank. That's why I invite each one of you come here. I think the more importantly, we're going to give God our praise. It's all by His grace. And it's all by God's grace. I am who I am. 1 Corinthians 5, 15-10. Actually, that was a verse, that was the very verse Reverend Moses shall preach in the 1992 December 30th. I still remember that vividly. I am who I am by the grace of God. So next slide. This is my last slide. I really don't have any big, huge, ambitious plan like Albert Lam. And if God allows me to live 121, gospel is the foundation. Gospel, next slide, transform the disciple. Each individual disciple come, join, become a covenant community, that's a church. But that church is called to serve him, to bring his kingdom, to proclaim the gospel of Jesus Christ faithfully to this watching world. In such a way that this community, different churches, AFC has privilege to connect multiple churches. I want to see this Catholic grandiose entire body of Christ come together. The gospel is our foundation. Each one of us been transformed by his grace, by his gospel. And the whole community manifests in such a way that's undeniable, that evidence to demonstrate that Jesus Christ is truly the Son of God. And he came to this world to save us, but not just save us so that we can go to heaven. He came to save us so that we can become a faithful ambassador for Christ. And I think that's, in the future, our entire AFC ministry will align with these four keywords: gospel, disciple, church, and his kingdom. So again, thank you. But more importantly, the last but not the least, I want to thank my wife. She's my Proverbs 31 woman. I also call her my BMW, beautiful married woman. It's 1989 BMW. That's the year we got married. So the mileage is high, but the engine's still going very strong. Again, from the bottom of my heart, and special thanks to Pastor Albert Lam, because Monday would be your 40th anniversary with Wanda Simu, and you came all the way to here. It meant so much to me. And each individual, I don't have time to say thank you, but I just fully recognize this is God's grace. Today I can stand here is not because of me, it's because of him. And thank you very much. Sorry, I was too excited. Just walk away. Actually, there's one very important event. If I don't know this, it's been great to miss. I think I would like to take the opportunity to, on behalf of the entire AFC staff members, and also it's truly an honor and privilege. For the past 7 years, I had the privilege to know my dear brother David. He's not only the president, but on a daily basis, on a weekly basis, he's truly my mentor and my friend. I still remember vividly the very first week when I met with David. When I get out his office, he tapped on my shoulder. He said, "Yo Cheng, when we at this leadership level, a lot of people only saying good words, 说跟我们说好话, but today I need someone can tell me the truth. Someone can 说实话. At that moment, I recognized David, his character, his Christian walk is such a huge impact and great model for me to follow. But I know it's not because of him, but throughout the past 7 years, through this close distance working together, I recognize David is truly humble servant, even though he just like Pastor Albert Lam said, he felt unworthy, but he said, this time God called him, he be here faithfully. So in the next few moments, I would just present a plaque to David to express the deep appreciation from the bottom of our heart on the entire AFC. We want to thank you for your past 46 years faithful service and your exemplary life in front of all of us. And I'll invite Roger also come forward and to present this gift together.
Would you please stand up, receive blessing from above. May the grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of our God the Father, and the fellowship of our God the Holy Spirit be with us all until we see you face to face. Amen. Amen. Please be seated.
Thank you, everyone, again, for attending the commissioning ceremony and also celebration of Dr. Bull. So I have a couple announcements to make. Important one first is we are going to have a retirement ceremony for Reverend Chow in November. So we are going to send out the announcement and the arrangement. So reserve that day in November of this year, okay. Number two, we prepared a lunchbox for each of you to go home. And oh, you can also have lunch downstairs in the basement. And more important, with something that lasts longer, we prepare gift bags for you outside. And if you haven't picked it up yet, that one lasts longer. So gift box, lunchbox, gift bag, lunchbox, and November event, right? Okay, yeah, thank you very much. And we're gonna have a photo, we're gonna take a photo and then Ike is going to give you more detail. Thank you.
Thank you, Warren. Thank you, everyone. This has been a very meaningful past hour. Now I'd like just to go outside. This is beautiful outside. Let's take a group photo, okay? You can leave your belongings here. And I know we have so many good friends over here. You know, I would encourage the board members to leave right now to go outside. We have a photographer waiting for you outside and follow my sign. And the rest of the guests, please follow along. Let's take that group photo first. And then you can come back to continue the conversation. And then we're going to serve the lunch in the fellowship hall downstairs. Thank you very much. I'll meet you outside.